I mean, I think what I'm hearing from all of us is that there's a recognition of an opportunity, but I'd like to actually call it an imperative. There is an imperative for this, right? That imperative is that for the next 30 years, this continent has to create 30 million jobs every year if it's to avoid an extraordinary youth crisis. That extraordinary youth crisis is actually potentially a political crisis, right? And you can't get these things done without elites, it's true, firstly. Well, it's also true that you need to kind of get people up, but you need political elites to kind of understand their self-interest.
Sure.
And I think that self-interest is about, we talk about the demographic opportunity, but actually that demographic opportunity is as much, if not more, of a threat than anything, right? So that's the imperative. But beneath that, what are the localized shared imperatives? Because I think that's what you need to identify. Because I think what we're talking about here, what everyone is pointing out, is there are special interests that are going to stand in the way of these things. So what you need to go in there, that's when I was talking about economic narratives. I think that the people who are running this thing have got to identify certain shared imperatives, right? And start to figure out how they kind of galvanize and negotiate around those shared imperatives. The fact that the rules of origin haven't even dealt with, for example, is a huge problem. People are saying the RECs work. Well, I don't know, SADC. Does anything within SADC actually, all of the commitments that have been made within SADC, do any of them matter? Does anybody implement anything? Do any of South Africa's partners take any of those seriously? Absolutely, absolutely not. And here we haven't even begun to define continentally rules of origin, right? So I think we have to be pragmatic about the fact that something like this is about trade-offs where we're all galvanized by the bigger imperative, and we need to start identifying, negotiating those shared imperatives, but turning them into narratives that we go back into our constituencies in our countries and sell those shared narratives. That's what I would recommend, but that's just because I'm in the art of narratives. So,
you know. You want to come in there?
Yeah, I think he makes a huge point. And the big point is that the larger vision that our leadership must believe in and must be willing to sell to their people is going to really determine whether this thing succeeds or not. Simply because we are also lost in our small local challenges, which are large, which are important. But I'm not sure that our leadership is yet taking that larger view, which is what will drive the unity that we are looking for. There might be sense for us to suggest that whatever is the framework that the Continental Free Trade Agreement has undertaken may now be passed on to all the regional blocks. Let the regional blocks start working on those regulations and agreements so that at least small parts of Africa start functioning as one unit, and it's far easier to implement it over an 8-10 country block than do it across 55 countries. That will then hopefully yield the way for a smoother transition into an eventual continental platform thereafter.
Guys, I think sometimes we forget why this is being implemented or why, what's the benefit of this. At the end of the day, as a business person, my unit cost of production comes down significantly. What does that mean for the individual? It means my cost of buying any good or service in my country is that much lower. So the $1 that I make goes that much further, right? Right now, in most of our markets, we import everything. Why? Because we've got very undiversified economies. So I think the other thing, I mean, it goes back to exactly to what Ramesh was saying earlier, is there are all these entrenched, you know, constitutions, entrenched sectors, because at the end of the day, the margins are significant. And what that means is I'm paying that much more. Bring in competition, those prices are going to come down significantly, and it benefits the entire economy. If we can't communicate that, if our technocrats can't communicate that value to the citizenry, then we have no starting point and no basis for making this successful at all.